Well, I want to congratulate Senator Johnson and Congressman Ribble for their leadership on this very important issue. Yesterday, you heard the president, as I did, tell someone in the audience that if you love me, you will pass this bill. Well, it's pretty clear that even Democrats, members of his own party, have lost that loving feeling for the president and his agenda. The fact of the matter is, as Senator Brasso has said, everything coming out of Washington these days seems to make it harder on the people we're depending on to create jobs, not easier, with predictable results, high unemployment, and the president increasingly desperate when it comes to trying to come up with a solution to high unemployment. But I'd like to just give you one quick Texas example of the EPA run amok. The Environmental Protection Agency does good work, but unfortunately it is out of control. And that's best evidenced by the impact of the cross-state air pollution rule, which has gone into effect and which has already killed 500 jobs in my state, the state of Texas. We've been suffering from triple-digit temperatures. Our electrical grid is operating at maximum capacity, yet what I'm told is because of the changes that will be necessitated by this rule, if it goes into effect in January, we'll lose about 8% of our electricity generation capacity because of this rule. But that's not the worst part about the cross-state air pollution rule as it applies to Texas. The fact of the matter is we weren't told ahead of time that we were even being considered for inclusion in this rule. That's right. We were not given notice and an opportunity to be heard. And frankly, the EPA, in an abuse of power, imposed this rule on the state of Texas, killing at least 500 jobs, maybe more, raising electricity rates on people on fixed incomes, and threatening the ability of our electrical grid to keep up with the air conditioning needs during triple-digit temperatures and endangering perhaps the health and safety of seniors and other vulnerable members of the population. So we need this bill to pass, and we need the administration to wake up and realizing that they're making things worse by this regulatory regime run amok and not better on the people we're depending on to create jobs.